Hello students, we are here again to study a new chapter in SST, that is natural vegetation, and this is almost the last chapter of second term portion. Okay, so let's start with it. Now, natural vegetation, the meaning of natural vegetation is related to the forest which grows by themselves. None of us or no human being helps them to grow. Okay. So if we talk about natural vegetation, let us first discuss what are the topics comes into this. Before we go to the text, let's find out some of the topics over here. So if natural vegetation is related to forest, what other things comes under this? Any ideas if you all can say? Let me see. Forest means, first of all, we need to know that in India, we live in India and we are talking about Indian vegetation. Okay. So India is having a different type of climates, different type of soils, different types of atmosphere, different types of places. So the forest will also be definitely different. So there are types of forest. First of all, we can see types of forest. And if we talk about types of forest, can anyone tell me what are they? First one is evergreen forest. We will talk about all these three topics later on. Now we are discussing only the topics of this chapter. After evergreen forest, deciduous forest. Okay. Then thorny forest. All depends upon the climate and the place. Okay. Next is mangrove forest. And the last one is coniferous forest. If we are talking about forest, what are the things related to forest more? The first thing is, we need to know the importance of this forest. What are the importance of why forests are need? Usefulness of forest. Why we need forest, or what forest provides us? You all may be knowing, forest provides us many things. Now please don't say forest give us fruits and vegetables, these are forests. So what we get from here is, the first thing is wood, which helps us to make furniture now. Next, we get many medicinal plants. Medicines we get from here. And then we can say, from wood only we get paper. So extra many things are there which we get from forest. So these are the importance or usefulness. It also helps us to bring rain and to protect from floods and all. So next, after this importance, something else is also there. If it is so important, we need to conserve it. Yes. So we should conserve our forest. Okay. And to conserve, there are many methods. Government has also taken many methods to protect forest and all. Some methods are there mentioned, and the first one is, you all must have heard this one. If not, we will learn in this chapter. Chipko movement. Chipko movement is what? When someone went to cut the forest, the tree, the people in those villages, they were very attached to the forest and they never wanted the forest to be cut down. So they hugged the forest, the trees, and they remained there only. That if you need to cut the tree, first you need to cut me. So this was known as Chipko movement. It was started by Bahuguna, Sundarlal Bahuguna. We will read about those one. Next is Van Mahotsav. And another things are measures undertaken by government and all. Many measures are there, measures of government. And here I can say, or rather I want to say, not only government, we also need to work on this conservation. Because if we can't do something, we should not harm also. At least we need to plant a tree. Okay, if we have space, plant a tree, herbs, shrubs, whatever you can around you. Okay, so now this is our map making of this chapter. What are the topics we are going to study in this? So let us go through the text and see in details what is evergreen, what is deciduous, thorny, mangrove, coniferous, and what are the more importance or what are the usefulness of the forest and how we can conserve our forest. Okay, so let's start through the